So now I will call the first speaker, Dr. Mouhamad Mpezamihigo, the Vice Chancellor of Kampala International University from Uganda. First, we will play the video, then you have 10 minutes to present your speech.
When you think of a university, you think of a place where you will go to cut out your future. And when you get there, you realize there's a lot more to it. The beautiful structures, facilities, and ambience. A place where you meet great minds, learn from each other, experience different cultures, as well as master the art of fundamental problem solving. Be part of a whole different study experience with Kampala International University, KIU, exploring the heights.
Okay, Prof. Mouhamad.
Thank you so much. If you can allow me to share screen. Can you allow me to share the screen?
Yes, Prof, you can share.
Okay. Allow me, because it is requesting that you enable me, please. Okay, very good. Thank you so much, Your Excellencies. I hope I'm audible. Al-Hadith, am I clear out there?
Yes, sir, you're audible.
Okay, thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, first of all, I would like to take this opportunity to give this talk with the understanding that I'm accepting this honorary professorship from the Academic Union. I really, really appreciate, and I want to put my discussion in context of the University of the Future. Honorable participants, globally, I want to say I'm privileged because I'm making this presentation, having had some very exciting and provocative talk by the two professors, one from Nnamdi Azikiwe and our colleague from Russia. I wish to say that I pledge that this honor that has been bestowed upon me today by the Academic Union will be protected, and I really salute the Academic Union. I also thank my university, Kampala International University, all the people, Professor Francisca, who is in the attendance, Professor Miriam, and the entire team, my staff members and colleagues who are listening. I wish to say definitely, we are looking at a university from a perspective of history. According to the British, a university was an institution that awarded degrees, their own degrees. And a university represented a collection of a community of scholars and persons of high level of intellect. It brings men and women together, who together create knowledge. We have the traditional fields and specializations. We also have, because of the global trends, we have disciplines that have emerged as a result of the global need. And so, according to my understanding, what I want to share with you is the fact that a university is a source of knowledge and a place where we have a power of professions. Over the past decades, a university has actually been redefining itself. And we know from its roots, it's from the Latin word universitas, which means totality. So you would expect that a university should be able to provide all-round training, skilling, competences, and connectivity. The university of the past was seen as a place for a selected few. Going to university was a privilege and very highly merit-based. Ladies and gentlemen, we shouldn't forget that already the population has expanded. There is massification of education institutions, and therefore over time, universities have had to be redefined if there are places that are supposed to address global changes beyond the ordinary awards, you know, giving of awards and being prestigious. My topic is looking at, do we need to cooperate or compete? I want to thank the people who asked the questions. I think cooperation is inevitable. It's no longer a choice. We have to build bridges. There are differences in society infrastructure, the technical systems, the fragility of different places of the world. And so in the globalization context, universities have got to cooperate. And we are so lucky and so unfortunate at the same time, lucky in the way that we are in the fourth industrial revolution, where we are in the digital era, where we can take advantage. We can actually exploit existing opportunities so that we are able as universities to cooperate. Competition can only be good if it promotes the elevation of those that are lagging behind. Now, the key thing for me, for cooperation, amid this globalization and internationalization is efficient, effective, and transparent communication. In the world of competition, there is a lot of hide and seek. In the world of cooperation, there is plenty of transparency. And the digital era has actually enabled this. Imagine this function. I'm somewhere seated in Western Uganda, in East Africa, but being recognized from Oxford. This wouldn't have been imagined. Imagine the hassle. And so this platform that has been created amid this globalization is what we should take advantage of. My theory this afternoon to you, ladies and gentlemen listening, is look at the pillars of cooperation. Number one, there is an inevitable environment of internationalization. And the fundamental question is, how do we apply ICTs and data science in order to enhance the power of cooperation? We do have repositories of information and resources. Number two, we all acknowledge the university demographics. We are in different places, we have different capacities, we have different populations, our human resources vary, our level of advancement and innovation also vary. That's a pillar. If we recognize that as our second pillar, we will definitely define how we intend to cooperate. Number three, which is really a prelude to our existing situation caused by the pandemic, COVID-19 has actually showed the fragility of our institutions in crisis management. How ready are we? You know, even those who were not talking are now talking. Even those who are much more aimed at doing business, you know, in selling resources to institutions are now becoming philanthropic. You know, that's really a reality that has come our midst. And therefore, I want to share what us at Kampala International University have actually done amidst this pandemic. We have established what we call the Virus Outbreak Data Network for Africa. And if you allow me, Mr. Al-Hadith, our chairperson, I'll just get to a place where I will show you that the Vodan Africa, with funding from Philips Foundation and Google and the commercial bank in the Dutch FMO, we've been able to increase access of information about health in order to predict the patterns of the pandemic. This for us has been an emerging scenario, and we are so glad that this can happen. We've been able to establish data points where we can now access information about the health in Africa and in Asia. And this is a clear evidence of how we can come together using data science, artificial intelligence, and the collaboration between North and South. I know Professor Charles has actually ably explained that. We have taken advantage of that and positioned ourselves. The second example is a very nice, very simple project where Kampala International University, working with partners in the North, have been able to actually develop a platform, an online platform, where we are going to increase access to the youth and women to develop employment skills. Look, we are Actually, no, we are working in Ethiopia, in Sudan, South Sudan, and also Somalia. And some of the courses that we are delivering online, which we are now in the final stages, working with Tilburg University, and also funding from our partners in the North and universities in the Netherlands, we've been able to develop this platform that is going to enable access to our people. So this is a model that we think and underfund, it's being funded by NUFIC, which is a Dutch international funding agency from the government of the Netherlands. And this is a demonstration that even within the pandemic, we can take advantage of this. Now, ladies and gentlemen, what I want to propose in my talk is digital cooperation. We talk about signing MOUs. How many of you have got memorandum of understanding that are seated in the shelf? Yes, with digital cooperation, I mean we should be looking at those who have and those who do not have. Let's look at the digital realities. Let's try to use ICT for development. We should all appreciate our system diversity. And putting all that together, we should be able to actually realize advantages of digital cooperation. Chairperson, as I come to the end of my talk, I want to introduce this concept of reverse linkages for the trailing world countries, for the trailing universities. Reverse linkage simply means that you have a big brother university or institution, whichever it may be, and you have a small brother institution. Rather than out-compete, rather than create trouble, you can say, look here, I do have this capacity. Can you come on our platform and we work together? So we have universities that are ranked differently, have different capacities, they have different niches where they exist. We do have government and non-government agencies. We appreciate the diversity in the education systems, but I'm sure with reverse linkages, we can actually pilot using digital technologies. We can pilot and envision common goals. We need to find some champions. I can say ably with a lot of pride that Kampala International University has taken advantage of this pandemic and has used digital technology with the partners in Africa and in Europe to actually pull out a very big project, which is going to help us for the years to come. Way forward, I think we should apply data science. There is no way, we can't afford to have staff and systems that are not upgradable. We must use our very, very best brains in the institutions to be able to adapt to technology. We should develop two-way systems, and I want the Academic Union, Oxford, to try and pick up this and see how we can form a big, you know, convergence point where the big brothers and big sisters in universities can actually assist those who are trailing. Let's understand the dynamics of internationalization. There's no more hiding. The education is now beyond borders, and technology can do for us that. Let's enhance cooperation and efficiency. Let's continue benchmarking. And therefore, I take this honor on this great day when I'm being honored to thank the Academic Union for your merit-based selection of the award I've just received, our Chairman, Board of Trustees, Kampala International University, and members, chairperson and members of the University Council, some of them, Professor Jessica and others, are in this meeting at the moment, the University Senate and Management, students, staff, communities, Professor Miriam Van Rensen, Francisca, Janice, and the entire Vodan and the DISH project team, the NUFIC team, members of my family and the media fraternity. I really thank you so much for listening to me.